First set, Coco Vandeweghe, ready, play. Last 15.
And if you're Risk, you want those elongated rallies. You want Vandeweghe in long rallies, test her shot tolerance.
Love 30.
Lovely start for Vandeweghe, love 30.
Oh!
And now she'll have to contend with three break chances in the opening game.
Her 15, getting in 14. A high percentage of first serves, that allows her to take control of points. She's got the big kicker, though, on the second serve that can keep her out of trouble. But for Risk, another break point. This is a chance to strike early.
And Risk will see the second serve.
Game Risk.
Double fault. Donates the opening game break for Alison Riske.
And for Riske coming into this match, she knows when those opportunities present themselves, when Vandeweghe is out of sorts, when she's not connecting, you've got to take advantage, because she can just blow so hot and cold within a set, within a match, that you've got to take advantage of it when she's not playing top-notch tennis. And this guy's not thrilled with what he saw that opening service game with his player. There's Pat Cash.
Alison
working with Vandeweghe on the grass.
That partnership paying immediate dividends at Wimbledon.
We've seen a lot of players come out first couple of games, some nerves. It's a new slam. So much expectation. And there for Risk.
Love it.
Coco donates the game with a double fault in the opening game, and Risk, first point, double fault. Both going to be feeling it.
Elise, in your playing days, how challenging was it to match up with someone that you knew well?
It's not. I never found it that difficult, because you can separate the two, and most tennis players can separate the two. Are you thrilled when you have to play early in an event? You got to play a good friend. No. but on this day you'll be thrilled to see your friend lose. Well, thrilled maybe.
30-15.
A little bit of an overstatement, but.
You'll celebrate your success.
Yes, if you're shaking hands and you're the winner, you will be relieved. Bring that up because today 40, I think 50. You see players more at the net. You see hugs sometimes at the net. They'll kiss each other after a match on the cheeks. When we were playing, that never, the only time it ever happened in my career is when I played my best friend. Plenty of time there. Very confident overhead is Coco Vandeweghe.
Game rings.
Risk takes the game at 30, able to validate the service break with the hold, consolidates for the two love advantage to start this opening round match.
And Alison Risk, she is smart out there on the court, and you see the depth. If she can keep Vandeweghe, keep Coco behind that baseline, and doesn't allow Coco to get around and hit the big forehand, she'll be the one with the upper hand. This is a huge game for Vandeweghe. Got to get that serve going. When she gets the serve going, that's how her game, it flows off the serve. When the serve is working, then she gets more confidence in her ground stroke. She becomes more confident going after returns. But when she's struggling with this part of her game, the rest of it has a hard time coming together.
The stat bears repeating. Vandeweghe leading the WTA for percentage of points won on the first serve, 73.8%. We've been talking about Pat Cash taking over the coaching duties in June. Wimbledon champ, got to the semis here at the U.S. Open in 1984. Vandeweghe broken in her first service game. Now half a chance at 15-30. Able to drop in the initial ace of the match.
They say it's better to serve long than in the net, so. And they're throwing in the serve and volley on the second serve, just trying to do something a little different, not confident off the ground at the moment. Probably took Risk by surprise there.
And takes the game with the effective combination. So Vandeweghe tallies, but she's down the early break, taking on Alison Risk on Armstrong. Unseasonably cool temperatures in the high 70s. No more rain in the forecast after the deluge yesterday until we reached the weekend. part of a robust year for American women's tennis. Three players in the top 20, seven in the top 50, led by the resurgence of Venus Williams, world number nine, reaching a pair.
Thank you. We're waiting.
Championship matches at the Slams this year.
Thank you, Ashes. Stop letting people moving in, please. Thank you.
So the ushers are figuring out the traffic flow here at Armstrong. It's been a little bit of an issue early on. And as you might anticipate, good crowd gathering to watch a pair of Americans.
Miss one by Chan and Nicole on the red base, both go down.
For the first time in this match, a chase review. Well beyond the baseline.
I thought it was a bit of wishful thinking for Vandeweghe there, but you got a shot of Riske while waiting for that. You see her kind of talking to herself. Riske is talking to herself, always pumping herself up. Always gets herself focused for each point. And this, the slice, not what Vandeweghe wanted. But she was right there for this one and just to put too much on it. And she responded in a way where she said, couldn't believe it. And those are misses you just can't have if you're Coco Vandeweghe when you set points up, down a break. Power of Vandeweghe.
14-15.
So often she'll overhit and she doesn't have to because she's just naturally got so much power that if she just kept it in her own lane and didn't try to overhit, she'd be fine.
Second double for Riske.
40-30.
Talked about her cerebral approach. Earned a scholarship to Vanderbilt before decided to turn pro.
We did get a shot of her coach, Yves Boulay.
Game Riske.
Compact service game for Alison Riske. Hold at 30, up the break.
Three games to one.
3-1 in the opening set.
Yves Boulay married to a former pro, Patricia He Boulay now, and Patricia He played at the time I played, was a very solid player, and she's helped influence those that her husband Yves works with. All about shot selection, and I'm sure Pat Cash is just pounding his head right there, knowing that Coco, you can't go for that much from behind the baseline. Try to go up the line. You've got to use what the court's giving you, rather than trying to force things.
Well, there's such a wide variation in her game. We've called the Australian Open together for years, and to watch her put it all together with such focus at Melbourne Park this year was tremendous. Defeating Angelique Kerber in the round of 16. Garbine Muguruza in the quarters before losing to Venus Williams in the semis. But the long period ensued that she simply could not win a match, and that continued all the way until May. Premier mandatory event in Madrid when she got to the quarterfinals.
And the side that is going to give you more points from Risk is the forehand. The backhand is extremely solid.
Vandeweghe steps it up, nearly dropping 1 point in that service game, but she's down the early break, taking on Alison Riske here on Armstrong.
3-2. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Find your seats quickly.
Here on Armstrong, this first round match is being contested in the top half of the draw, upper quarter. This is Karolina Pliskova's section, the top seed who made it to the finals a year ago. Focusing on American tennis with Alison Riske.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
At Coco Vandeweghe.
Please, any seats available, please.
Riske able to cash in on the break to start this match. Serving 3-2 as the fans make their way back to their seats here on Armstrong.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the back of the court, please, stop moving in, please. We're ready to play.
Great sense of the dimensions at this temporary stadium.
15 left.
One thing Vandeweghe does is she takes very big swings. She takes a big loop, big swings, and the bigger the swing, the more chance for something to go wrong. And that far back behind the baseline is not where Coco wants to be, but that's where Alison Riske wants to see her. So it's Riske doing a nice job holding Vandeweghe at bay.
Outstanding shot making on display from Alison Riske.
40
left. You can see how focused she is and always ready to play aggressively when it presents itself. Got down beautifully to that last backhand.
Game Riske.
Able to wrap up the flawless service game. Hold to love.
Riske leads 4-2.
First closer set. To finalizing in this opening set.
That's just a beautiful serve. Wonderful fluidity in that motion. Over 6 feet tall, gets that angle in the deuce court out wide.
Good for a second ace.
Right 15. Now, going for those shots, she just doesn't have the feel at the moment. You think that she just needs to dial it back a little bit, but in her mind, she's got to be thinking, I'm going to get it. It's going to come. I got to keep hitting out on the ball. Seen her sneak in on a couple of second serves.
Just been 15, off 15. The mark. Unable to find the depth on a majority of those groundies. Feeling more score, more pressure here at 15:30.
Because the word you said.
Bullshit?
Yeah.
Bullshit's a warning?
Wow.
Yeah.
Well,
according to what?
No ambiguity there.
That language is not good.
It doesn't get bleeped out on TV, so I don't know what you're talking
we
about.
We have so many microphones.
Get your point. She can move it when you serve. Coco Vandeweghe just said a lot.
Mm-hmm. And we'll touch on it. And what she's complaining about is Riske moving. Well, there's nothing wrong. Riske can stand where she wants. She's doing it to get into Coco's head, and she has gotten into Coco's head. If she hadn't been, then you wouldn't have heard that come out of Vandeweghe's mouth. And you know, there's a difference between the language. You're going to get called on the language, but nothing that Coco was complaining about what Riske is doing, moving around like that. That there's nothing illegal about that. She's not distracting.
That felt like deflection.
Yeah.
So we'll see if Vandeweghe can maintain her focus here.
When your opponent's doing what Riske is doing,
30.
Is it annoying? It absolutely is, but it's not illegal, and it's up to you. It might not make you happy, but you've got to block that out. And Ally Risk knows that's getting in her head. I'm gonna do what I do. And what she's trying to do is give Vandeweghe different looks on her serve, trying to give her different looks so that she doesn't get into that service groove.
Deuce.
Put a stamp on that, the word that she used. She knows she's going to get called on that and acted shocked. No, she knows. You can't say that. If you say it, you're going to get a warning.
Risk with a chance to pick up the insurance break.
Ms. Ray Pachetan, call on the red base.
Take the chance with the chase review.
Goes over to replay again.
Well worth that opportunity.
Advantage risk.
So Risk picks up the second break of the opening set. Four words from Vandeweghe, and Risk will try to serve it out here on Armstrong. The supervisor has been called here to Armstrong.
I'm just trying to have some information, and she
So Coco Vandeweghe's had her set. After she got the warning for language, use of profanity, and then also wanted to articulate the fact that she believes that Alison Riske has not been stationary when Vandeweghe is preparing to serve. So this match becoming spicier as we've arrived at the business end of the opening set. Riske, with the benefit of new tennis balls, trying to serve it out and consolidate her second break.
And that was Donna Kelso coming out. She's been with the tour for a long, long time. She knows the players well. She knows Coco Vandeweghe well. She knows Coco's kind of just venting. Donna's saying, we'll keep an eye on it. But I think in the back of Donna's mind, she's thinking, okay, I don't think Alison was doing anything that was not legal.
No, I think wisely defusing the situation. With a major opportunity here for Alison Riske, trying to wrap up the opening set. And Coco getting into semantics about words you can and cannot say now on television, depending on what you're watching.
And if you're Alison Riske right now, saying, yes, I'm in her head. And that's, you never want your opponent to know that she's gotten to you. And honestly, you've got to think some of this, it's just nerves. So much expectation for Coco Vandeweghe. Semis at the Australian, quarters of Wimbledon. She's on a hard court, her favorite surface.
Well aware of her personal history here in New York City. She's never made it past the second round of the U.S. Open. Set points for Alison Riske. That completes the efficient opening set for Riske. In less than 35 minutes, she takes it 6-2 here on Armstrong. Well, some of the drama towards the end of the first set overshadowing what has been a tremendous year in American women's tennis, highlighted by Fed Cup action. Colleague Captain Kathy Rinaldi leaning on Coco Vandeweghe. She's won 8 consecutive matches in Fed Cup play. The Americans getting set to take on Belarus for the Fed Cup title in November. Vandeweghe has more pressing concerns here, looking to rebound in this opening round match after dropping the first set to Alison Riske 6-2.
Talk about Fed Cup and Coco Vandeweghe has relished taking the United States team on her shoulders and carrying them to the finals of Fed Cup this year. And it's been wonderful to watch her in that venue. Kathy Rinaldi has had a gem in Coco Vandeweghe, and she has been such a pick-me-up and such a leader for that team. And talking to Kathy before this match, she was just shaking her head. Did not want to see her two of her players have to go against each other in this opening round.
And it feels like Coco, just watching the competition, really feeds off the team concept of Fed Cup play. Because when she gets astray emotionally, it can be challenging
30.
For her as an individual to compartmentalize.
Correct. And if this was a regular week on tour, Pat Cash could come out on the court and coach her and calm her down. But you got to self-coach out here in the Grand Slams. It's one of the reasons that I'm not a huge fan of the on-court coaching. If you can't do it at the slams, I'm not in love with it the other weeks. I understand that the television component is interesting to listen, and it gives players an opportunity to supposedly play their best, but it's a sport where you've got to figure things out on your own, especially in the big events, in the Grand Slams. And this game for Vandeweghe, so important that she gets off to the better start than what we saw in that opening set. It just set the tone the first game.
40-30.
And that's her second double of this initial game of the second set.
Not
able to rebound with the service win.
First game, second.
And holding that first game should let Coco just relax a little bit. That's the one thing she hasn't been able to do. Having lost that opening service game of the match, she was just behind the eight ball and just never could get herself to relax and play her type of tennis. When she's playing well, her ceiling is endless. She has a very high ceiling. Is her ceiling much higher than Alison Riske? Yes, it is. But if Coco Vandeweghe is not playing, if she's playing halfway to that ceiling, then someone like Alison Riske is going to take advantage and will beat her. That's beautifully done, using the pace that Coco gave her, and I love the way this, especially on that backhand. Look how she gets down here. The knees to the ground, gets so low. And a big fan of that backhand.
Court cooperating. For Coco Vandeweghe.
For Riske, serving a very high percentage of first serves. You saw it in the 80s in that opening set. Very cerebrally, knowing that if she doesn't let Vandeweghe get looks at second serves, she's going to be in the positive position, playing from strength.
And knowing Coco's patterns, having played twice before this year.
Game wins.
Economical service game, the hold at 15.
Second set.
On serve to start this second set.
From Vandeweghe there, those ground strokes. usually at the U.S. Open, it hits that net court, and a lot of times it bounces back, but these have been going Vandeweghe's way and just clips the top of the tape, and the return of serve from Riske was tremendous on a good first serve.
40-9.
Good for ace number three.
Just a beautifully flowing motion on that first serve. Greatest 1-2 I've ever seen. That is just tremendous, the return and that volley.
40-15.
Watch this volley. What a return. And then the volley was just so good, solid. From her shoe tops. Doesn't get better than that.
It appeared Vandeweghe might have a love service game instead. Still more work to be done. Takes it with the ace and a flash of emotion. Vandeweghe hoping to find her sink. Serve to start the second set after she dropped the opening set to Alison Riske, 6-2. Slow start for Coco Vandeweghe in this one, broken in the opening game, matching up with fellow American Alison Riske. Riske, the world number 49, able to cash in on the additional break in the seventh game of the opening set. Back it up with the consolidation.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Ready for me. Thank you. Thank you. At the back of the court, any available Riske. Seats?
For world now, number 49 please. Serving in 1-2 early stages of the second set.
Thank you.
Alison not too far away from her career high, ranking of 36 in the world.
Quiet, please. Thank
and
you.
Still waiting for a handful of tardy spectators to find their seats. Look at the setup here. Temporary Armstrong before the glittering new Armstrong debuts a year from now.
And
there, Vandeweghe just pulling up on that forehand and just not confident in terms of hitting her ground strokes repetitively with consistency. And Riske, you know what you're going to get with her. You're going to get a player who will be solid all the way through, short and compact on that forehand.
Appeared to be ideal placement, but Vandeweghe wants to take another look with the chase review.
Look at Yves Boulay, coach again of Alison Riske, and he'll be happy seeing that one. Smack on the line.
Well, Vandeweghe has two challenges.
If it's a quarter on, it's smack on.
I think a smidge is the technical term. If you're on the line, everything is clicking. And it's working so far for Alison Riske. Trying to maintain her momentum.
Better points we've seen off the ground from Vandeweghe, and I like the way she started it.
13.
She started it straight up the middle, but had pace and had depth and worked the point from there, and then finished hard up the middle with that forehand. That's, she's got so much power. It's all about shot selection. There, you're just getting that sense of Vandeweghe feeling a bit more confident. That slice was perfect. Cardia thinks, go to a tighter racket. The ball just, it at times just flies off her racket. Don't go for so much and just let your incredible natural power take control. It's almost about harnessing that power. Vandeweghe comes down to a lot of harnessing the power. Harnessing her emotions, which got out of control for that period in the opening set, not letting things bother you.
Alison Riske staying the course, extended in that game. The tallies once more.
Two games on, second set.
She has not faced a break point in the match. A reminder, you can stay connected to the U.S. Open on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, and YouTube. Join the conversation with the hashtag U.S. Open. Level of two on serve in the second set.
15 love.
Good second serve.
14-11.
Not wide, but out short in the court.
Game one.
That's precisely what Coco Vandeweghe was searching for. Love service game, trying to raise her intensity. 3-2 on serve in the second after she dropped the opening set to Alison Riske, 6-2 on Armstrong. Celebration of American women's tennis at America's Grand Slam Tournament, day three of the 2017 U.S. Open. Aaron Armstrong, Coco Vandeweghe, the 20 seed, taking on Alison Riske. Riske using a pair of service breaks to take the opening set 6-2 here at the USTA. Billie Jean King National Tennis Center on serve, 2-3 in the second. U.S. Open Series.
Thank you.
Risk.
Players are reaching
the round of 16 at Stanford University in the San Francisco Bay Area. The event that Coco Vandeweghe made it to the finals. And then Risk, not much momentum at both Toronto and Cincinnati, losing in the opening round of both of those Premier 5 events.
Better from Coco Vandeweghe. Love the way she put a little more air on the forehand right there, getting a little spin. She's got so much power that you put a little spin and you get more control. And you're Alison Riske on the other side. And you know, now I've got to bear down because she's playing much better.
Miss Vandeweghe, channeling the call on the left bases. The ball's pulled out.
Coco wants another peek with the chase review. The players often have an innate sense. I'm sure she'll enjoy that.
That's the look of, are you kidding me? How did you miss that one? Now this is where you can have a little smile about it, but don't lose your focus. That's where you just gotta stay focused on the task.
Third double fault for Risk. Now she's under a bit of duress. Love 30.
So for Alison Risk right now, the computer in her head is it's scrambling and knowing that Vandeweghe's playing at a higher level than she was in the opening set. Now if you're Risk, how do I deal with this? How do I make my own adjustments to a player that is now playing at a much higher level? And in this situation, not a ton that Risk can do. You just got to be patient and wait and hope that she cools off.
First break points that Risk has faced in the match. Equal to the challenge.
30-40.
So the latest change in momentum favors Coco Vandeweghe, grabbing the first break of the second set.
4-2,
looking to consolidate. Having watched Vandeweghe play over the years, such a wide spectrum.
The pendulum, it swings. Yes, it can be swinging wildly. We talked about the ceiling, and the ceiling for her, for Vandeweghe, is so high when she starts putting it together, even within a match. And this is a different player than the one we saw who started things off. It could have been different had that opening service game gone differently, but she came out a little nervous, came out a little cold, and that set the tone for that first set. It's so apparent that she was feeling the nerves, feeling the pressure. And now she's done a very nice job of calming herself down emotionally, which has allowed her better tennis to come out, allowed her to make good decisions.
Regaining her rhythm, just poured in her fifth ace, and now the points come in quickly.
49.
For the world number 22. Trying to consolidate this break with emphasis.
Net. Seconds.
Seconds. I know you like the tactic there. Didn't need the volley after the massive serve. Love service game to validate the break. Vandeweghe game away from forcing a deciding third set. The tone with opening game break. Backed it up with a break in the seventh game as well. But in the second set, Coco Vandeweghe finding her range. Came up with the first break of this set. Able to consolidate. So now it's Riske serving to stay in set number two. Crowd really filling in the shaded area. Seats still available on the sunny side.
Right now, you need to focus on holding serve, and then you just try to figure out a way to get the break back. Vandeweghe a little casual with that volley. Did a nice job getting herself in, but right here, a little cash hitting that backhand volley. You gotta hit it deep or you gotta hit it very short, but not in the middle. Sign that Riske is feeling it, feeling the pressure from Vandeweghe.
Her fourth double fault. Still has some margin in this game at 40-30.
Get those points with that camera angle because you can really see the pace on the ball and there you could see the real power of Vandeweghe. Now it can be overwhelming.
Help. Advantage Riske.
The smile is what on earth was my that return I just hit.
Another clean winner off the racket of Coco Vandeweghe.
Deuce.
Good margin, not overhitting, not going for too much. It's still overpowering.
Advantage.
Break point is set points. This was broken in the last service game. Back in the danger zone here.
What a difference that first serve makes. Gets the good first serve in, which gives her the short reply, and Risk makes no mistake with that forehand. Telling herself, hang in there, because we've talked about as hot as Vandeweghe can play, she can then blow cold, and you've got to bide your time and wait.
Second. Deuce.
Risk up to 5 double faults.
Anything short to the backhand, she leans on that very well.
It was all in front of Alison Risk. This could be wishful thinking with the chase review. Has to be stunned at what she did there.
She knew. She was in such shock. She just had to challenge. She did everything so beautifully, setting the point up. That's a killer.
But able to rebound with the effective combination.
And now what you admire with Risk is her just sheer focus and a bit of that amnesia, just left it behind and focused on the next point.
Approaching 8 minutes and 30 seconds within this game. Vandeweghe will get a look at the second serve.
Game Risk.
Risk staying the course. She does her part, but Coco Vandeweghe will have the benefit of new tennis balls as she hopes to serve it out and take this match to the third. After Vandeweghe was unable to cash in on a set point.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please find your seats quickly, please. This is not a changeover.
Posing herself. Coco Vandeweghe. Putting more air on the ball in her forehand. Giving herself more margin.
Risk of challenging the call on the left near center. The balls go down.
Well, not much to lose strategically for Risk with this chase review. Can't take it with you to the third set.
Consent. 30 line.
Two punch that serve out wide. Glenn Risk so far off the court.
Miss Risk has one challenger.
And giving herself the easy volley. That will make Coach Pat Cash thrilled to see that, giving herself the set points.
Three more after Vandeweghe had a look at the set point in the previous game. So it's a major reversal here on Armstrong as Coco Vandeweghe is feeling it. First set was played by Alison Riske, 6-2. Second set belongs to the 20 seed, Vandeweghe, 6-3, heading to the third. And Riske will, Alison Riske has returned, and we are ready for what should be a compelling third set. First round match that was rained out yesterday here on Armstrong. So many individual chapters in this one.
Any of
stands filling up with a sense of urgency now mounting for both players. It's Alison Riske and Coco Vandeweghe. The spot in the second round on the line.
And the opening game of both sets set the tone. In the first set, it was Vandeweghe dropping her serve and just couldn't really get it together from that point. And then in the second set, Vandeweghe had a good first service game and got her game together beautifully.
Vandeweghe briefly losing her footing. We'll get another look at what she was dealing with beyond the baseline.
Hey.
14-15.
Double fault number six for Risk, who had a couple in a single game towards the end of the second set. Only been broken once in this match, but it was critical. Game number six in set number two.
Game,
but able to settle in with a comfortable hold at 15.
First game, finals.
And that was very important for Allie Risk, who lost any momentum in that second set. It was really torn from her by the play of Coco Vandeweghe. And you don't want someone who can be such a fabulous front runner like Vandeweghe to feel no pressure. You want to make her feel it. And so that game took on some real importance for Risk.
A snug setting here on Armstrong.
And another shot at Yves Boulay, the the camp of Alison Risk, her coach. Yves in the green, lime green.
Fluorescent, I think the kids call it.
And this is an all-court time of day. Shadows start overtaking the courts. I kind of feel like I'm on the old grandstand where the shadows would come on and be. You really have to focus, and they're both going to have to really pay attention.
Vandeweghe now up to four double faults in the match. See the shadows creep their way across the court.
When you're a player, especially if you're playing a big server, that can be very tough, and the big server is Vandeweghe here. Nice return, and it started with the decent return. If you're going to serve and volley,
15-15.
You have to volley up, you're going to be in some trouble. And that's exactly what Coco had to hit the half volley, and then Alison Risk just taking control.
Half a chance at 15-30. Second double of the game.
15-14.
Major opening for Alison Risk. A pair of break chances.
Net. First. Net.
Third double of the game that donates the break directly to Alison Risk.
Right service line, the ball
pending confirmation from the chase review. Risk moves ahead.
Game
two risk. Love to start the final set.
So we saw in that
Risk
opening set when
two games to final set.
When Vandeweghe dropped serve and got down, she just never recovered, and now she's going to have to recover. She's got to pull it together upstairs so that she can allow her game to flow the way it did in that second set.
Love 15.
For Risk, it's keeping that first serve percentage high. Got depth off the ground. You keep that ball deep, it's you're going to make Vandeweghe hit more balls. And when she's feeling uncomfortable and when she's down, she's not as free-flowing as we saw in that second set. She tightens up, makes more mistakes.
Now it's Risk in danger of handing the service break right back. 15-30.
That's just beautifully done by Risk. It was a good return from Vandeweghe. It was deep, but she dealt with the power magnificently, held her ground, got down low, and just used the pace from the Vandeweghe racket to redirect that winner. So good.
Ah! 30-40.
No challenge here.
Nothing more frustrating when you play the point like you played the previous one to give it away so quickly. Real chance for Coco.
So once more, momentum is temporary in this match. It's an exchange of breaks as the drama builds. 2-1, third set on Armstrong. Over after the exchange between Coco Vandeweghe and Zhang Zhuan in the chair. Coco got the warning.
Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats quickly, please.
You know, there's a level of respect you still have to show to the person in the chair and a way that you can express it. And
thank you at the back of the court. Find your seats quickly.
Had the umpire really heard that final thought that came from Coco, it could have been possibly a point penalty.
Yeah, there was a period on that sentence. There was not punctuation. So as the stands continue to fill here on Armstrong, just over 8,000 seats available. It'll be Vandeweghe trying to consolidate her break after players trading breaks. 1-2 in the third set.
Thank you. Love 15.
The only thing that Vandeweghe should be focused on is her tennis, and you know that conversation, that's a distraction. Conversation with the umpire about suggesting that she tell the ushers to close the gates before she says time, and it's Coco wanting to control the traffic patterns also. Doing a nice job there leading into that return to serve. Not easy coaching a mercurial yet extremely talented player. That's something that Coco Vandeweghe and Pat Cash have probably worked on, him telling her, you've got this amazing kick on your second serve. If you follow it in every now and then, you're going to get some free points, and that's exactly what she got there.
Battling back to 30 all.
Alison Riske doing what she does best, and that's playing solid tennis, not giving anything away.
A point for a third consecutive break. Coco was on the move. It did not matter. Riske, solid return.
Three games to one. Final.
Able to seize the break, make it three straight service breaks. Riske moving at 3-1.
Oh, Allie Riske ready for that one. Said, fool me once with that serve and volley on the second serve. Not going to get me 2 points in a row in that ad court, and she was ready for that.
Fault.
Second serve, took a little bit of a chance. She flattened it out, 89 miles an hour, and she was rewarded for it.
Net versus. 30-15.
Risk does not have an ace in the match. It's been much more about placement and precision.
And that one, it's all about just connecting with that ball, and just so much power. Clean winner. Big point for both.
Out. Miss Vandeweghe channeling the call on the left baseline. The ball's cooled down.
Heard the media call by Zhang Zhuan in the chair. Here's the chase review.
Constant.
And Vandeweghe knew.
40-30. Miss Vandeweghe has one challenge.
The frustration. No, she gotta make Risk play off that return.
Use.
Three breaks in a row out here. Can Risk hold and consolidate the second break of the set for her?
Instead, a chance for a fourth consecutive service break.
Advantage, Vandeweghe.
Vandeweghe converting 2 of 4 break points. Double fault for the break. 4 breaks in a row. Three, two, third set on Armstrong.
Ladies and gentlemen, please find your seats quickly. Thank you. Time.
Ideal conditions for day 3 of the 2017 U.S. Open here at the USTA Billie Jean King National Tennis Center. Intriguing. Third set. Here on Armstrong continues. Early on, it was promising for Alison Riske when she grabbed the break. Good for the 2-love advantage, but that was the first of 4 consecutive breaks. It's Vandeweghe looking to consolidate a 2-3. And she's dropped in ace number 6
15-11.
Winner of the match will take on Ons Jabeur of Tunisia, best known for her play at the French Open in the second round. She took care of the American wild card. Brand Miner, the NCAA singles champion for the University of Michigan, 6-1-7-5 on court 10.
Service game, we saw our serving volley a couple of second serves. The first time it worked, the second time, which was the break point, she paid the price. There, serves and stays back, gets the short reply, and just as good as the serving volley.
Risk covering the court well.
30-15.
She's looking for that serve and volley off the kick. So as much as it's kicking up, Risk with that short backswing on the return can handle that, and it's getting those returns down. Not hitting a winner off the return, but setting herself up. It's old school how you would play a serve and volleyer. Under 13 miles an hour.
40-15.
Got the pace and also had the placement.
Her seventh ace. Back-to-back aces at last. A break is consolidated. Coco trying to fire up the crowd here on Armstrong. Level at three in the third.
Three games.
Reminder, final we do set. Have tiebreakers in the final set here at the U.S. Open.
Coco Vandeweghe, you're somewhat at her mercy. You know, the mercy of her level of play. And when she's off, you've got to take advantage of it, because when she's on, there's not much you can do. For Risk, she knows a shot like that. She's got to be ready for that return and can't give anything away. If she overpowers you, that's one thing, but neutral balls, you've got to stay in those points. And she's feeling it. She's feeling it on the return, and she's going for these second serves. And the last game, she double faulted, hitting a flat second serve to lose her service game, and now the double fault there.
Her eighth double of the match. Previous one was highly costly. Handing Vandeweghe the break. Has to bear down here at 15-30. Vandeweghe controlling that rally with her power, drawing two more break chances. Dictating the terms, as you can see, as of late, it's an 8-2 run.
And that's an example of being at the mercy of Coco Vandeweghe and all that power.
Next.
Coco converting 3 of 5 break chances. Vandeweghe's got it. And she's got the lead. 4-3.
Score!
She tries to consolidate the latest break, drawing closer to a winning equation here on Armstrong.
4-3, final score. Ladies and gentlemen, please find your seats quickly. Thank you. Time.
Well, this final set has largely been contingent on the mental component of our sport. 5 breaks in 7 games. Latest one wrapped up by Coco Vandeweghe. Good for the 4-3 advantage as she tries to back it up with a hold. Vandeweghe takes another point. Ignited by the first serve, and statistically, that's been the trend of the match. When she's gotten the first serve in, she's won 20 of 24 points.
And then that just frees her up. And I like off of the ground, she's not trying to paint the lines, she's using the middle more. And then that's opening herself up.
30 line.
And then go for her shots.
Tallying her 9th ace.
40 line.
Double fault number 7. The 15 to consolidate the break. Coco Vandeweghe now just 1 game away from moving on to the second round.
There you see the weapons of Coco Vandeweghe on full display, the power, the ability to control points, to take it to her opponent, to really render an opponent helpless in terms of dealing with her power.
Alison Riske serving to stay in the match and prolong her run at the U.S. Open.
That Riske needs, and of course, got a hold serve here and force Coco to serve it out, see how she can deal with the pressure of serving the match out.
Drawing closer, 30 all. Alison Riske does her part. Still, the match will be on the racket of Coco Vandeweghe trying to serve it out. Book a spot in the second round of the U.S. Open.
Thank you.
Time. We saw five breaks in the first seven games of this third and final set. The last one claimed by Coco Vandeweghe, who was able to consolidate. Now a chance to serve out the victory and move on to the second round of the 2017 U.S. Open.
The first step for Riske was holding her own serve, and she did a nice job of that after dropping it all those consecutive times. But now, how do you deal with the serve of Coco Vandeweghe? She's shown that she's willing to serve and volley every now and then, mixing the serve up well now.
Very
that's a step in the right direction for the 20 seed. who has been broken four times in this match. Just over 2 hours old. Service winner, and it's 30 love.
And what's been most impressive about Vandeweghe is how she regained composure. Composure that she lost in the opening set. Got it back just in time.
Triple match points.
14-9.
It's a win for Coco Vandeweghe. She was extended, but able to persevere and is moving on to the second round of the 2017 U.S. Open.